الله وسلامه عليه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
We are still talking about the seven conditions of لا إله إلا الله. سبعة شروط للا إله إلا الله. The first one is العلم, knowledge. The second one is القبول, acceptance. The third one is اليقين, certainty. Number four, الانقياد, is to be submissive or submission. الانقياد. خامسا, الصدق, honesty. سادسا, number six, الإخلاص. Number seven, المحبة لله. Number six was الإخلاص, and that is sincerity. Number seven, المحبة, is love towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We started to talk about the sixth condition. الشرط السادس, الإخلاص. Sincerity, dear brothers and sisters, is the base. هي القاعدة for any deed or any عمل that the human being can do. And we mentioned the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, that they were only ordered to do what? To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with complete sincerity. This is the main reason. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا. I have surely created the jinn and the human beings for the sole purpose of what? Worship. And since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us for this sole purpose, He wanted from us complete surrender and complete sincerity. إذ قال لقمان لابنه وهو يعظه يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. لقمان, the wise man, some people said he was a prophet, some people said he was a wise man. تفضلي حاجة. What did she say? She wants to distribute this to the people, inshallah. See what it is.
Luqman.
Luqman, alayhi salam, the first thing he taught his young son, his young boy, he said, my boy, my son, be careful that you don't associate anyone, any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that surely association is the gravest, is the most dangerous, is the biggest of sins. And we mentioned last night, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive association with Him, or when we associate partners with Him, but He surely is forgiven of anything other than that. Subhanallah. So it's extremely important to have al-ikhlas. This is a fitna. We should do this after, inshallah.
Yeah.
That the ikhlas, the sincerity, is the basis of any deed. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Barakallahu fi mri'in amala amalan fa'atqana. May Allah bless the person when they do the deed or they do the work, they do it with detail. They do it with ikhlas. They do it with sincerity. They do it with complete and utmost workmanship, craftsmanship. They do their best. And to Allah is the greatest example. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. When we are to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to have complete sincerity after we have completely surrendered to Him. الإخلاص التام بعد الإنقياد التام. As we are worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to make sure that this worship is absolutely and sincerely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants it to be. This is what's extremely important that we have been talking about throughout the different conditions, because they all tie into one main characteristic, and that is La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. So there are going to be a lot of common threads within the characteristics themselves. الشروط كلها تتفق في هذه الأشياء. So if we look back and we see that when you surrender your will, you surrender your intellect, because mashallah, after getting a few PhDs, some people get really confused. They think the intellect is going to take over. But yet we ask those who use that intellect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always telling us to use the brain. Absolutely. We're not downsizing the brain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always mentioning لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ أَفَلَا تَتَذَكَّرُونَ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. والبصر هنا ليست الرؤية, هي البصيرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us with this brain for us to use it. But this brain is not to exceed the limits that Allah has given it in the capacity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given it. Because if you want to challenge something in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I come back to you and say, Akhi, are you a believer? Are you Muslim? He said, of course, ana, mashallah, mu'min billah, everything's good. I said, what makes you believe in Jannah? I can't, can you understand this with the brain that there is a Jannah? Sincerely, the Jannah is something you really have to believe in. It's not something you can really, really explain with the brain. You can't come to someone who doesn't believe and say, man, if you become Muslim, you're going to go to Jannah. What are they going to do? Huh? They're going to laugh at you. You say, what are you talking about? And the Kuffar of Quraysh said this to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam before. 1400 years ago, they said, if we are bones and dirt, that we will come back to life? Are you serious? So, موضوع البعث, coming back after death, needs belief. Yes, the brain can tell you, okay, this makes sense. This can be logical. هذا يمكن أن يكون منطقي. But you really have to believe this. Because we have millions of people that don't, and they are known to have lots of brains. الإخلاص. The sincerity, first of all, needs you to be a humble human being. Not only towards the people and the creatures and the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but most of all and first of all for you to be in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you hear the orders of Allah, you don't have an issue with that in your heart. You accept it, even though you might say, wallahi, it's going to be hard for me. But you accept. This is going to help you have sincerity towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I just read a hadith not too long ago that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He gives sincerity to those whom He loves, so they will be sincere in worshiping Him. نسأل الله من فضله. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestow this sincerity in our hearts so that we may love and want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ وَلَمْ يَقُلْ يُحِبُّونَهُ فَأَحَبَّهُمْ أَوْ يُحِبُّهُمْ. It's not that we love Allah, so by consequence Allah loves us. No. Allah loved us, by consequence we have loved Him. So the fact that you are here tonight, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are of those that He loves. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are of those that He will forgive in this blessed month of Ramadan. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgive us from all of our sins. And that He elevate us in this dunya by doing what? By being obedient to Him. And that He elevate us on the Day of Judgment by dying on this obedience in this dunya so that we may be elevated in the akhirah. Qulu amin. Al-ikhlasu fi al-qawli wal-amal. To be sincere in what you say and in what you do. So we always have to be extremely careful what we say and how we say. Because what is on your tongue is usually a reflection of what's in the heart. مَا فِي الْقَلْبِ يَلْزَمْ أَنْ يَظْهَرْ عَلَى الْجَوَارِ. What's in the heart, sooner than later, will manifest itself on the limbs. If you love Allah, you'll jump out of the bed and you'll start crawling to the washroom so you can wash your face and get ready and get up and come to the masjid or pray at home with your wife. Jama'ah. Because that's the best jama'ah. So you guys need to smile. So. Just joke. So on. This sincerity that's in the heart is going to manifest. How and when? And I want to conclude with this, inshaAllah ta'ala, because we can talk about sincerity for a long, 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 long time. But our goal from this is to talk about little things to trigger thought processes so we can go and research and find out more, inshaAllah ta'ala. The sincerity, dear brothers and sisters, this is extremely important, is for you to know in your heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa razzaq. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sustainer. Is the one who is going to give you the rizq, the sustenance. When you know that without a doubt, and the more you have this knowledge, and the stronger this knowledge is in your heart, the further away you will stay from haram. When they tell you this is haram, you're like, wallahi, a'udhu billah. What do I need to do? This is what you need to do. 1, 2, 3, 4. مَنْ تَرَكَ شَيْئًا لِلَّهِ عَوَّضَهُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا مِنْهِ. Whomsoever leaves something for the sake of Allah, be assured that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace him with that which is better than what he left. Guaranteed. But you, I, all of us need to have this. It has to be a pillar in our hearts. Knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you find a better job because you left that which is haram, is going to help you move on to the next level and get out of that which is haram. Are you going to struggle? Absolutely. Are you going to feel like, I don't know how I'm going to make it? Absolutely. Are you going to get to the point and say, I wish I would have never listened to Muhammad Susi? Absolutely. Are you going to get to the point where you're going to tell your wife, I wish I would have never listened to you? Absolutely. Are you going to get to the point where you're thinking you're going to be begging just to eat? Absolutely. I'm telling you this up front, so maybe you can be mentally ready. But once, dear brothers and sisters, أقسم بالله هذه بالتجربة. This has been tested over and over and over and over. And I want to conclude with a story of a brother whom I know very, very well. True story. There's a brother who used to work in finance. And used to make